Thank you for watching, and in this video we are going to launch SolidWorks first time, and I'm going to explain the interface of the SolidWorks and all the things which you should know before starting your modeling. So if you already installed the SolidWorks in your PC, so you can see an icon of SolidWorks on your desktop which looks like white and red, as you can see on my screen. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to launch the SolidWorks, so I'm going to double click on this icon. After opening the software, you are gonna see such kind of view on your screen. So SolidWorks have three basic modes. The first one is part, the second is assemblies, and the third one is drawing. And under these modes, you can see there is an option for recent documents. So what you can see is, you can see all the recent documents, whatever you open with this software. So under that mode, you can see there is an option for recent folders, whatever the folder you already opened the software. And on the right side, there is an option for resources, in which you can find some kind of communities. So what's new in the SolidWorks, if you want to check the support, user groups and customer portals. And on the top right side, you can see there is an option for the login, so you can log in. And another side is, like, you can see on the left top side, like, there is option for file, view and tools. So we are gonna cover all in upcoming videos. So let's go into the part first, and then I'm gonna explain the interface of SolidWorks. So right now I am into the interface of part, but the drawing and the assemblies interface are pretty similar. So there could be all those options, so which I'm gonna explain in next videos. So when you are into the SolidWorks, so this is the first interface you are gonna see, and then you can see here are different options. So these row is called tabs. So if you have, might be if you are gonna open software, so might be you could not see all these options. So because I have a couple of things which are customized for my software, so the SolidWorks is a configurable software, so you can have multiple things according to your desires, or whatever the custom designs or toolbox you want to see, you can see on your software. So the first thing is, which I am going to explain, these are the tab menu. So what you can do is, as you can see, like, if you are going to change the tab, so right now I am into the feature tab, and above the tab menu you can see these options. This is called ribbon section. So whenever I'm going to switch the tab, so you can see the ribbon section is going to change. So might be you cannot see this many tabs on your software. So if you want to add some tabs, or if you want to skip some tabs, so what you can do is you can right click on these tabs anywhere, and then you can go into the tabs. So if you want to bring some tabs, suppose I want to bring surfaces. So you can see this surfaces tab is here, and into the surfaces tabs, you can see all the options into the ribbon section. And if you want to disappear this surfaces tab, so what I'm gonna do is, you can click any of these tabs, you can right click, and then you can go into the tab, so you can uncheck the surfaces. So in this way, surfaces is gone. So let's disappear the weldments. So I'm gonna go again into the tabs, and I'm gonna uncheck the weldments. So in this way, I can just get rid of weldments as well. So this tabs is called tabs menu, and this section is called ribbon section. Sorry for distraction, but if you think my videos are helpful for you, or if you are a serious SolidWorks learner, I'm gonna highly recommend you can go into the description of this video, where you can find my course link, in which I have over 10 hours of videos in which I explain each and every command in a detailed way. Thank you. Okay, so the next important part is feature manager. So on the left side, this manager is called feature manager, and here you can see there are dozen of options. So right now, as we are here in the part, so that's why it is gonna start with the part. And then there is a history, you can see the all the parts for whatever you open into your SolidWorks, so you are gonna see here into the feature managers. So other than that, there are options for sensors, for annotations, for markups, equations, materials. So if you are gonna draw something, or if you are gonna design your part, so you can change the material. So if you want to change, what you can do is you can just right click and go, and you can go into the edit materials, and then you can design, or you can choose whatever the material you want to have. And there are three basic fundamental planes. The first one is front plane, the second is top plane, and the right plane. So you can take them as a piece of paper. So when you are gonna draw, or when you are gonna design your part, so you need a paper, so where you are gonna draw. So These are the basic planes which you need to choose. So you can choose front plane, top plane or right plane. It's up to your design or it's up to your requirement. But most of the time I prefer to design or draw on front plane. But in upcoming videos, we are gonna choose different planes and then we are gonna start our designing. Okay, the last option is origin. So when you are gonna start your drawing, so it is stated or it is gonna start it from at origin somewhere. So you can see this is a coordinate system, or you can have multiple coordinate system as well. And whenever you are gonna bring your cursor on this line, so you can see this cursor is gonna change into a hand icon. So whenever you are gonna design, so all the options or all the designing sketches or features all are gonna here one by one. So as it's a history based modeling software, so what you can do is you can just hold your hold this line and then you can move it up or down. So in this way you can see how a part is designed, or maybe I can explain in future videos. Okay, so here into the center you can see there are different options. The first one is zoom to fit or zoom to area or previous views, or you can see a section view of any part or any 3D body, or you can have annotation views. Here you can have different kind of orientation. If you want to open your part in whatever the view you want, you can open. And here you can see display styles, if you want to hide some parts, some areas, or if you want to change the appearances, if you want to change the color, you can change the scenes, or you can change the settings. So all these settings are here. So I would like to show you this, but right now I don't have any part or any sketch here. Otherwise I would show you this in upcoming videos. So you don't need to worry a lot, because we are gonna use all these options into upcoming videos, and every tool and every option is gonna use in different videos. And then the third important part is here. As you can see, here is the SolidWorks resources or the SolidWorks design library, or I have a file manager here. I have a view palette, or I have appearances and scales if I want to change, or I have custom properties if I want to change custom properties or any specific parts. Or there are some other toolbars here which might be you can't see on your software, which I already customized here. So if you want to choose different tools bar which you need to use multiple times, so you don't need to go again and again, so what you can do is you can just open those toolbars and then you can stick them anywhere on your software. Or if you want to see, like, there are some options which are not gonna here into these tabs or things, so what you can do is you can just right click anywhere here and then you can go into the customize. And here into the customize, into the toolbar section, what you can do is you can choose whatever the tool you need, or you can go into the commands here. And if you want to use any of these commands, what you can do is you can just drag these icons and then you can bring into your ribbon section and then you can use that. So in the next videos, we are gonna use some commands from here. So I'm gonna show you how you can use them. Another important part on this interface is if you are gonna go onto the below downside, you can see there is an option for IPS, because right now we are into the IPS unit system. So if you want to switch between the unit system, what you can do is you can click on this tiny triangle, so you can see all the unit systems are available here. So right now we are into the IPS, which is inch pound seconds, and if you want to move into the millimeter gram seconds, so I'm gonna select this MMGS. Or if you want, then what we can do is we can edit document units. So in this way we are gonna go into the document properties and we are here into the unit. So what you can do is you can choose your unit system here, and then you can choose the number of decimals, how many number of decimal do you want, and some decimal rounding setting here. So these are the four important parts of this interface. The first one is ribbon section, feature manager, library, and this unit system. So whenever you are gonna go into your part or into your assemblies, so you would see all these options, and even most of the options are available in drawing as well. So in the next video, what we are gonna do is we are just gonna draw our parts one by one, and you don't need to worry, we are gonna open and use all these commands and tools we are gonna use in different videos. And that's all for today's video. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, don't forget to hit that like button and subscribe to our channel for more videos like this one. And if you are a serious SolidWorks learner, then don't forget to check the course link in the description. Thank you.